Hello, my name is Sharif, and this is our third tutorial video where we're still going over how to create mobile workspaces for the Dynamics 365 for Operations mobile app. In the first two videos, we created an all sales orders page, which you see on the right hand side here on my Android device, which allows scrolling the list of sales orders you have in operations. And in the second video, we showed how to design a details page and a navigation that allows you to navigate from an item in this list to its details inside of the mobile app. All right. So now this third tutorial video, we're going to talk about how to create an action which allows adding a sales order to this list from within inside of the mobile app. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to edit our mobile workspace. We're going to select sales order management, which is the mobile workspace we've been working on through the tutorials. We'll click the edit button. And now we want this action to appear on the all sales orders page, right? So we're going to select the all sales orders page and edit it. Then we'll click on actions. And now we'll go ahead and add our action. And this action is going to be one that allows you to create a sales order. So we'll call it create new sales order. There we go. And now we'll click done. And now we're in the place where we can start editing our action. So as I mentioned in the previous tutorial video, the magic button is the select fields button. And it has an intelligent system behind it that tells it when it should be enabled and when it should not be enabled. In this case, the system understands that it can only be enabled when the form that is currently open, in this case, we're open to the dashboard, when the form that is currently open has an entity that matches the expected entity for the particular data context this action is attached to. In this case, this action is sitting on the all sales orders page. And the all sales orders page, the backing entity for it, or rather the backing entity for this list is sales table, right? So the create new sales order is going to light up once we're on a form that has the same backing entity as this page. So we go to all sales orders. There we go. And we see the button has magically been enabled. And now we'll go through the same process we went through before when we were designing the list page, or rather designing the page with list on it and designing the details page inside of our mobile app. We're going to open a top level form and we're not going to make any changes to it. We're not going to click anything on it. First thing we're going to do is click select fields. All right, and now we're in the design mode. We see the orange border around the form. Now we're going to go ahead and execute the process that's a part of creating the sales order. And that process involves clicking the new button on the all sales orders form. All right, so it's important that we click the new button while we're in the design mode, while the orange border is there, because the mobile system is now, the mobile framework is actually going to capture clicking of the new button as a part of executing this action. It's going to click that new button for the user automatically when they do this action on the mobile app. All the user needs to do in the mobile app is fill in the customer account. So we want to add customer account as an editable field in our page. Right now we have no editable fields. So we can go ahead and just set the customer account. We could click the plus button beside these other fields if we wanted to add them. While we're designing an action, sometimes we'll see the plus button doesn't appear beside the field, but that doesn't mean that it can't be used. It just means that you can't use the plus button as a shortcut. It means that you'll need to, you know, change a value in the field or set the value in the field. In this case, we're just going to set a value in our customer account field so that it's added to our action design. In this case, I'm going to use US-001 as my customer account. I'm going to go ahead and type that in. Press tab. All right, we see the field has been added to my design for the action over here. And we'll see all the rest of the data has been defaulted for us, so the user won't have to enter the delivery name, address, and so. Now, the third step as a part of my action, you know, the first step being clicking the new button. The second step being entering a data value here, the customer account. The third step is going to be click OK. So I go ahead and click OK while we're still in the design mode. This is actually going to create a new sales order on operations for me. This is creating real data. All right, but now once that data is created, you see this pop-up appears. And this is coming from the mobile framework inside of operations. The mobile framework detected a CRUD operation, create, read, update, or delete operation. And the reason that the mobile framework automatically ended the design mode, you'll notice that the orange border is gone and we can now select fields again. The reason that it automatically ends the design mode is because it recognizes that the process should be complete. You've created a new entity, you've created a new sales order, and that should be the end of this action. This action shouldn't have any other side effects. It shouldn't create and then delete the sales order, and it shouldn't create the sales order and then update other entities. This is our way of making sure that we understand this is a create action. Right? And this create action won't have any other side effects. So when the user is in the mobile app, and let's say they're offline in the mobile app, when they create that sales order, we'll be able to add that sales order to the list here while they're offline. And we'll understand that there's no other related information that needs to be updated in the mobile app because there are no side effects. There's just a temporary sales order we'll create and we'll synchronize when that user gets their device online. All right, so that's important. Making sure that this dialogue appears when you're done designing your action is very important. Sometimes this dialogue won't appear automatically after you've done something like a save or after you've done something like a new or delete. And when this dialogue doesn't appear, what that means is that it means that that action probably won't work well when the user's device is offline. It means that whatever way in which you've performed that CRUD operation on your backing form code or your backing table code, it means that that CRUD operation isn't discoverable in a way that the mobile app expects. Usually what that means is that you've edited, created, saved, or you performed that operation on an entity that wasn't the same entity as we expect for the action or we expect for the backing page. In this case, we created a new record in sales table, and sales table is the backing entity for this list, so everything is going to work as we expect. We'll go ahead and click close here. All right, we're done designing our action. So we're gonna go ahead and back out. This will take us back to the page that has the action, the all sales orders page. So we're on the actions tab here. And our fields are still here. Nothing has changed as far as our fields for the all sales order. We're still gonna see this list in car style. We'll go back one more time. This takes us back to the mobile workspace, the root level part. We'll go ahead and click done and save. This is gonna override our existing changes. Great. Now, remember, every time we modify the metadata for the mobile workspace, we need to pull to refresh from the workspace landing page. So we'll go ahead and pull to refresh there. Now, when we go into sales orders again, we're going to see the actions now appear at the bottom because we've added an action. Now the action bar appears at the bottom. We go ahead and open that action bar. We'll see the option to create a new sales order. Let's go ahead and open that. There we go. And there's the one field that we expected to enter data into, the customer account. So now all the user has to do is type in a customer account number such as US-001. There you go. And now when the user clicks done, something magical is going to happen. So it's important to understand what's happened so far. So far, a user has simply opened the action on the mobile device. At that point in time, the user has no session. There's no service call being made to operations to the AOS. This entire process can be done offline. No form code is being executed as a user opens this action and as a user types in or selects this value. The form code won't be executed until the user clicks the done button. When the user clicks the done button, what the mobile app is going to do is it's going to take that data value, US-001, and it's going to put that data value into the metadata for the action. You know, the action metadata is a description of how to process that action on the server. And that description contains those three steps we described before. That description contains the fact or the step of clicking on the new button. Of course, you have to open the all sales orders form as well, but the framework will handle that for you since it's a root level form. So the action definition says, you know, on the all sales orders form, click the new button, enter in a value for the customer account, and in this case, use the value that the user typed in to the action in the mobile app, and then click the OK button. Right? So those two things are going to happen for the user automatically when they click the done button here. I'm going to go ahead and click done. All right. So that process has completed on the server, on the AOS. And we see we have a temporary record here in the mobile app. And now that temporary record is filled in with our new sales order. All right. So the user clicks the done button, and then we process that change on the AOS. If the user's online, we process it immediately. If the user was offline, we would simply navigate them back to this list, and they would see that temporary record, and that record wouldn't get its final information until they reconnected again. But if they're online, then we'll leave them on the action, and they'll see the syncing notification there, let them know that we're processing that action. And then the mobile framework is going to go out to the AOS. It's going to create a new session with that user context, and of course, with that company context, USMF. It's going to open the all sales orders form, which is a top level form. It's going to click the new button on that form. It's going to enter into the customer account field the data that the user typed in, US-001, and then it's going to click the OK button for the user automatically. So all that is happening as that action is being processed and synchronized with the server. Once the process completes successfully, the server is going to tell the mobile app. The mobile app navigates the user back to the list of all sales orders, and it shows the user that temporary record, saying we successfully created a record for you on the server, but there's still some more information from the sales order, such as the sales order ID that we don't have yet. So because we recognize that we created a new sales order, we need to refresh the data on this page for the user automatically. Since the backing entity for this page is sales table, and we created a new record in sales table, the mobile app is automatically going to queue a refresh for this list. So the user will see the temporary record while that refresh is being processed. And once the refresh is done, they'll see the actual data for that new sales order. All right, so that's an end-to-end example of how to create a very simple action for creating a record. Some important topics there are making sure that your entities match up, making sure that, of course, the backing entity for your action is the same as the backing entity for the page that the action is going to land on. And in our case, our action was created from the exact same form. It came from the all sales orders form, so everything's good there. We're using the same backing entity. In the next video, we're going to talk about how to make that add a sales order experience a bit more user-friendly by adding a lookup to the customer account so that the user doesn't have to type in the customer account number.